100, Morning Emerson, Bernie Sanders, and Ted Cruz came out their party's winners in the Wisconsin primaries.
And Iceland's prime minister has resigned after the leak of the Panama Papers.
All that and more today, Thursday, April 7th. I'm Lauren Fox.
And I'm Sean Stackhouse. Welcome to our EVVY special. Today, we'll be unveiling the nominees of these EVVYs Majestic and Gala. Lauren, are you excited to hear the nominees?
I am so excited. And in fact, I might need to calm down a little bit, and you might need to calm yourself down before we release the names of the EVVYs nominees. So fitness correspondent Caroline Long is going to show us the power of meditation.
It's going to be great just to relax. But now, for today's headline story this morning, Vermont Senator Bernie Sanders and Texas Senator Ted Cruz were victorious in this week's Wisconsin primary. Sanders won 56.6% of the vote, gaining 48 delegates, while Cruz won 48.8% of the vote and added 36 delegates. On the Democratic side, former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton now leads Sanders with 1,280 delegates to 1,030. As for the Republicans, even after losing Wisconsin, Donald Trump holds a secure lead over Ted Cruz with 732 delegates to 505. The next caucus will be on April 9th in Wyoming, and after that will be the New York primary on the 19th. New York will be an extremely important state for Democrats, with 247 delegates up for grabs. According to the CBS News poll, Clinton leads with just about a 10-point lead, while Donald Trump reportedly holds a 31-point lead with 12 days to go.
Thank you, Sean. And right now we're going to go to Chloe Teboe with the latest political upheaval in the fallout of the Panama Papers.
Thanks, guys. Here are today's developing stories. Yesterday, Iceland's Prime Minister Sigmundur Gunnlaugsson officially stepped down after the recent revelation of the Panama Papers this past Sunday. Gunnlaugsson has been accused of hiding millions of dollars worth of family assets in a British Virgin Islands offshore account that he owned with his wife. He denies doing anything wrong. Gunnlaugsson is only one of dozens of global figures involved in the 11.5 million leaked financial and legal records. On Monday, thousands of people protested outside of the Parliament building in Reykjavik. Consequently, Gunnlaugsson stepped down ahead of a confidence vote in Parliament for a, quote, unspecified amount of time. The major corporation PayPal took an unprecedented steps against a North Carolina law discriminating against gay and transgender people. On March 23rd, Governor Pat McCrory approved a law in Charlotte, North Carolina that blocks cities from creating non-discrimination policies based on gender identity. This law excludes gay and transgender people from legal protection and requires that students in state schools use bathrooms corresponding to their gender assigned at birth. In response to this recent legislature, PayPal has canceled its facility in Charlotte, which was expected to employ 400 people. More than 100 other companies have joined in protest of this law. PayPal, however, is the first to cancel jobs in the state. Farther north on the East Coast, on Tuesday, 21 people were arrested in a fake university scheme. The University of Northern New Jersey was established by the Homeland Security Department as part of an operation to catch criminals involved in student visa fraud. Those arrested had acted as brokers who recruited foreign students to this institution, though they were aware real classes did not exist. The brokers then charged 1,076 students in a plot that would supposedly allow them to keep their student visas and stay in the United States. Those individuals arrested were generally legal residents or mainly naturalized citizens. Finally, today, right here on campus, Emerson College will be hosting its first TEDx event on April 9th from 1 to 3 p.m. TEDx Emerson College will feature faculty, student, and alumni speakers and is based on the theme Evolution Through Expression. Students Shao Rondeau and Amanda Canny will also display videos based on racial diversity in the college and the mental state of depersonalization. This event was organized by students Anna Tenowitz and GME's own John Pooley. Though TEDx Emerson College is open to the public, only 100 seats are available, so be sure to request tickets at tedxemersoncollege@emerson.edu. That's all I have for you today. Back to the desk.
Thank you so much, Chloe. I'm going to go back to the resignation of Iceland's prime minister. Do you think this is kind of only the tip of the iceberg of the politicians that are going to resign as a result of the Panama Papers?
Yeah, Lauren, with this huge reveal, I think we're going to see a lot more issues emerging in the upcoming weeks. And so I think it's something we're really going to have to look out for to see who we uncover who was involved in this issue.
Thanks so much, Chloe. And now for today's weather forecast. Today will be rainy with highs in the upper 50s. Hold on to your hats because wind gusts are going to speed up to 40 miles per hour this afternoon. Today's rain is expected to go into both Friday and Saturday with highs sticking around 50 degrees. On Sunday, we will finally see the sun again, but temperatures are expected to stay in the low 40s. At least we're not seeing any snow in the forecast, Sean, so it'll be a little disorienting for me. I'm still wearing my Canada Goose knockoff all the time now, and I'm like, it's April.
You know, I made the mistake over spring break of bringing my winter coat back home, so now I've just been relying on multiple hoodies. This has not been the best idea.
Oh, man, Sean. We're going to have to take a quick commercial break, but when we come back, Gala host Peyton Dix will be here to announce the nominations for this year's EVVYs Gala Awards. Good morning, Emerson, of course.
Good morning, Emerson? What's that?
It's the best morning show ever that's on Tuesday and Thursday at 9 a.m.
Wow, how can I work on this?
Yeah, let's get going. Red leather, yellow leather.
Welcome back to Good Morning Emerson. I'm here with Peyton Dix, one of the hosts of the EVVYs Gala. Peyton, are you excited to reveal the nominees this morning?
I'm very excited. I'm really ready to see if any of my friends got nominated or, you know, maybe myself.
All right, well, let's get started. Here are your nominees. Outstanding Integrated Marketing Campaign, STEM Bar Integrated Marketing Campaign, Leah Bruyar. Harley Davidson Bicycles, C. Zoe Cronin. Hampton Inn Brand Integrated Marketing Campaign, Leah Bruyar. The Olive Connection Marketing Communications Plan, Capri De Beccari, Dinesh Monani, Austin Mon, Kayla Van Fleet, Matthew Zani.
Outstanding Advertisement, Second Pizza Ad, David Samuels. Redbrook Housing Community Print Advertisements, Leah Bruyar, MYOP Ads, David Samuels, Be Good for Petal Juice, Michael C. Thorpe, Hansi Audate.
Outstanding News Article, Gilmore Girls Reunion Panel at ATX Television Festival, Bring Stars Hollow Back to Life, Nora Dominic. Clergy Sexual Abuse Survivor Reacts to Spotlight Win Existing Epidemic, Priscilla Ligori. Nominations could be locked up after Super Tuesday, Andrew Lamos, Paul Philbin. Debate is very important, Rand Paul says, Angelina Salcido.
Outstanding Sports Article, Department Says NUMAC Success Within Sight, Matthew Case. Mets Sweep Cubs Advance to World Series, Jack Ross. Celtics Notebook, One Season Later, Isaiah, Celtics Shine, Tom Little, Holy Cross, Michigan going to round of 64, Tom Little.
Outstanding review, Allegiant fails to capture spark of the books, Aaron Graham. Son of Saul, Real Reactions Review, Harrison Jeffs. Review, Star Wars, The Force Awakens fails to fully embrace the Force, Michael Macchio. All new X-Men 40 review, Michael Macchio.
Outstanding blog, Lion's Tooth, Malcolm Kellner, Charlie Greenwald, YourMagEmerson.com, Madeline Billis, Karen Morales, Joanne Paquin, Atlas Blog, Charlotte Slota, Lauren Lopez, Margot Sapil, Caitlin Mucho, 5 Cent Sound Blog, Lindsay Gonzalez, Isabel Diona.
Outstanding Video Blog, The Side Dish Oscar Special, John Daniel Luna, Arden Yerskis, Max Filippi, Silence is Golden, The Quiet Road to Spitfire Grill, Joe Hornberg, The Jukebox, The Ghost Remembers, Vlog 10, Zane Shaw, John and Arden take on the Taco Bell Triple Dare Challenge. John Daniel Luna.
Outstanding prose fiction, Till When, Till Man, Amy Russo. Night of Broken Memories, Sofia Alvarado Mendoza. They Said, Rachel Smith. Hand Dog Company, Amy Russo.
Outstanding prose nonfiction, Two Summers on the FV Ace, Benjamin Gordon. For Us, Christina Barston. Gaslit, Marissa Tandon. Inbound, Alexandra Estrada.
Outstanding print publication, Atlas Magazine Rebel Issue. Writer staff, M Magazine, Extreme Issue, Austin Wilder, Andrea Fernandez. Your Magazine, December 2015, Peyton Dix, Haley Sheriff, Matt Mullen. Index, Emerson College Fashion Society.
Outstanding photography, Morning Light, Nick Eaton. Government Center, Mason Muchnick. Kaleidoscope Portraits, Jenny Chapman. Contemporary Nostalgia, Robert Teamstra.
Outstanding poetry, Senior Poetry Collection, Capri Dibikari. What Doesn't Belong in Boxes, Brianna Origi. Flight 1026 to Budapest, Emily Hillebrand. I Am Leaves, Jenna Coleman.
Outstanding web design, 5 Cent Sound Blog, Lindsay Gonzalez, Isabel Dion. The Hateful Eight promotional page, David McLaughlin. Underground web fitness design, William Hart. EIVnews.com, Andrew Lamos, Jimmy McGinnis, Kate Bell, John Pooley.
Outstanding internet broadcast, The Laundry Room, Airing the Dirty Laundry, James Rowland, Lauren Bennett, Paige Morgan. Emerson Channel Sports, Emerson Men's Basketball versus Clark, Daniel Sheehy, Connor Judge, Joe Jacobs. The N Live from Boston, Eddie Hickey. Emerson Channel Sports, Emerson Women's Basketball versus Wellesley, Daniel Sheehy, Connor Judge, Joe Jacobs.
Outstanding musical multi-track recording, Ron Mann, Nathan Jocks. VVWMS Super Smash Radio Edit, Andrew Sclafani. To You, Nathan Jocks. Falling from the Sky, Nathan Jocks.
Outstanding stand-up comedian, David McLaughlin, Maggie Calcane, Wesley Houghton, David Carliner.
Outstanding supporting actor for the stage, Elias Dante Flores, A Doll's House. Pierce Campion, Murder at the Carlsons. Dallas Seeker, Murder at the Carlsons. Andrew Cianez de la O, A Doll's House.
Outstanding supporting actress for stage, Amanda Breen in The Marvelous Oz, Rachel Hunsinger in Alchemy of Desire, Dead Man's Blues, Kathleen Klein in A Murder at the Carlsons, Kristen Schlemelzer, A Doll's House.
Outstanding short video, Hide and Seek, Sean Vaccaro, Kyle J. Kozaka, David Bradburn, Even the Homeless Have Wi-Fi, and Blue Dreams by Jack Romanoff, Amo Stilwell, Taylor Jarvis, Harry Brownstein, Vegan on the Weekend, Writing Team, Lotus Flower, Sean Vaccaro.
Outstanding beginner film, Morning Glory, Emily Jacoby, Simona Darren Samuels, MK Ultra, Columbia Crandall, Tessa Lottie Music, Video, and Andrew Bushnell, Rude Jiang Ung.
We have to take a quick commercial break, but congratulations to all of those nominees. When we come back, Lauren will be sitting down with photographer Karen Jerzik, who will talk about her trademark style. We'll be right back. Lauren, what are you doing?
I'm getting ready to host Good Morning Emerson, of course.
Good Morning Emerson? What's that?
It's the best morning show ever that's on Tuesday and Thursday at 9 a.m.
Wow, how can I work on this?
Yeah, let's get going. Red leather, yellow leather, red leather.
Thank you.
Good morning, Emerson. Today I'm here with photographer Karen Jurczyk. Thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you.
So your photography has a very particular style about it. Can you kind of describe it for us?
Yeah, what I try to keep consciously in mind when I'm taking photos is I kind of want my images to be almost like a pulling a scene out of a movie. So when you look at the photo, you can kind of try to wonder what happened before I took it and what happened after. So movies have a really big impact on me, and I've always been into film. So that's what I always try to do. I try to storytell with my photos, so with lots of wardrobe and concepts. And
yeah, and like a movie, I'm sure it requires a lot of other production elements. Do you have like makeup artists, costume, that kind of thing?
Yeah, I work with Ashley Rose. She's a wardrobe designer, and I work with her very well. We kind of bounce ideas back and forth. And sometimes I have a makeup artist. It's hard some of the places I go sometimes. I'm not supposed to be in them, so I go to a lot of abandoned places. So
can you give some examples?
Like abandoned hospitals, houses. I try to get permission as much as possible, but sometimes it's hard. So I've gotten myself into some trouble by doing that. But it's really hard sometimes to bring in like a crew of people. But when I can, yeah, I try to have like a makeup artist, wardrobe designer. Sometimes I make my own stuff if I need to, if I'm in a bind, but yeah, I usually have a team of people when I work.
And are they kind of cautious about some of these places or maybe even some of these ideas that you have sometimes?
Not really. I've been lucky to work with people that are like cool with it. If I do have to go somewhere where I don't necessarily have permission, I'll be upfront about it. But everyone's been really cool, and you know, we all travel a lot, and we're all into kind of like the same vision and the same, you know, aesthetic. So I have pretty much like the same like dozen people that I work closely with. So.
And one thing that I saw on your website was that you were a self-taught photographer.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I was actually an English major, and I didn't do anything with that. But I actually started taking photos when I used to go to concerts. I used to sneak a camera in and try to get up close and take a bunch of photos, and that kind of translated to ending up getting photo passes. So I shot concerts for probably like 10 years. And then one of my friends was like, oh, you should try just taking photos of people, like models and stuff. And I was like, I don't know. But so I started doing that, and then I kind of strayed from the concert photography, and now I'm at where I'm at. So.
Oh, great. That's inspiring for all of us rookie photographers. Now we're going to have to go to sports reporter Malcolm Kellner with your latest on the Red Sox start of the season recap.
Thanks, Lauren. Despite inclement weather pushing the Red Sox back, their opening day back a day, the Sox got off to a great start with a 6-2 win on the road in Cleveland on Tuesday. So could they follow it up with another W on Wednesday? Top of the sixth, Sox down 5-2, but as local rapper Malfi would say, I'm on my David Ortiz. Big Poppy with a massive bomb off Indians starter Carlos Carrasco. The next batter, it's Hanley Ramirez going oppo taco to right center to make it 5-4. Great piece of hitting by Hanley. Then in the seventh with the game tied at six, wait, that guy looks familiar. It's Mike Napoli. He's on the Indians now, and he comes back to burn his former team with a solo blast off Junichi Tozawa to give Cleveland the lead again. Then top of the ninth with two outs, last chance for the Sox. Could Big Poppy do it again? Deep fly to left field, but it's caught at the wall. Red Sox come up just short and lose 7-6 for their first loss of the season. The UConn women had been storming through the NCAA basketball tournament at a historic level, wrecking everyone in their way. Standing between them and a championship was Syracuse. Could the Orange pull off the miracle upset, or would Brianna Stewart and the Huskies capture their fourth straight title? There's Huskies coach Gino Auriemma. I'm sure he's incredibly nervous about how his team will stack up. First quarter, we're going to start off with some Brianna Stewart nailing the pull-up jumper there. Then later in the first, it's Stewart from beyond the arc this time nailing the three. You know what? I think we might as well just show highlights of her. End of the second quarter, UConn already with a 25-point lead. Stewart pulls up and drills the long two. Then in the fourth, how about another three ball? Yes, ma'am. She finished with 24 points. UConn cruises to an 82-51 victory for the national title. Stewart wins her fourth most outstanding player of the Final Four award. Yes, she won it every year of college. Unbelievable. I wonder who will be number one pick in the WNBA draft this year. Just kidding. I don't wonder at all. Unlike the Bruins, the Celtics have long solidified their spot in the playoffs. But what's still up in the air is seeding. With only five games left to play going into Wednesday, the Celtics were one of four teams in the 3-6 spots separated by only one game. So a win against the Pelicans would certainly help. Isaiah Thomas has his game face on for the Seas. We're going to jump all the way to the fourth quarter. Game tied at 89. It's Thomas crossing over one defender. Then fan love. Show some love to the fans. Then he goes, next play, Luke Babbitt for the Pelicans, nailing the catch and shoot jumper to tie the game at 93, but the Celtics answer back to retake the lead. Thomas dishes to Avery Bradley, hits a tough pull-up jumper of his own. Then with just over 30 seconds to play and the C's up by four, it's Thomas to Bradley again for a three this time. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is what we like to call a dagger. Celtics would seal the deal and win it 104-97. They currently sit in the fourth spot in the Eastern standings, but have the same record as the Atlanta Hawks, who are in third. Now, in very local sports news, Emerson College moved to the new MAC conference 2 years ago, but one team stayed in the old conference, the GNAC, the men's volleyball team, since there's no men's volleyball division in the new MAC. The Lions claimed the sixth spot in the GNAC playoffs and went on the road to face third-seeded Riviere on Tuesday night. Despite playing the Raiders very tightly, losing the first two sets by only 6 and 3 points respectively, the Lions fell 3-0, and their season came to an end. With the loss, it brings an end to the illustrious careers of multiple seniors. Outside hitter Jackson Wiley finished with more kills than anyone in Emerson history. Brendan McGonigal was one of the best setters to ever don an Emerson uniform. And libero Jared Gross ranked third in all of NCAA Division III this year in digs per set. Those and the Lions' other seniors will be sorely missed. That's all I got for sports today. Back to Lauren and Sean at the desk.
All right, thank you, Malcolm. Are you feeling stressed about finals only being a few weeks away?
Oh my gosh, Sean, you don't even know.
All right, I am too. Well, our health and fitness correspondent, Caroline Long, has the best ways for you to meditate this spring. Let's take a look.
Hey guys, I'm Caroline, your health and fitness correspondent. I'm here with Gabby Mancuso, who's a freshman WLP major. And so Gabby, we were looking at your Instagram and it seems that you've gone under a little bit of weight loss and you've really gone through a lifestyle change. Can you tell us a little bit about how that kind of started?
Yeah. When a year ago, I got tickets to Coachella and I was like, oh my God, I need to be in a bathing suit. And so I started running and I started doing a lot of cardio and Coachella came and went and I realized I really, really liked the way that exercise made me feel and eating better made me feel. So I took it to the next step and I went full vegan and I started doing a lot of yoga. Come 2016, I started doing a lot more weightlifting and stuff and it's just completely changed my life. I feel clean on the inside.
So if you have maybe your top three tips for people maybe coming into college, looking to make a new lifestyle change, would you have any advice for them?
Yeah, definitely it's always love yourself first. Next one is just stay motivated, but also don't beat yourself up for slipping up. And I guess the last one is just stay balanced.
Exactly.
Yeah. And so have a brownie, but also have a salad.
I've been told you're gonna show us how to make some smoothies.
Yeah.
So let's get to that. So Gabby, can you tell us what's going to be in this smoothie of yours?
Yes, absolutely. So I have soy milk. I usually just put a cup of this in. I just fill it up to the little line. And then I have hemp protein powder, chocolate from Trader Joe's. So I just take a scoop of this. We have chia seeds, and I just sprinkle a little bit in there. Lastly, a banana because it tastes yummy and has a lot of potassium in it. Okay.
So aside from your smoothies, I noticed you have a little bit of snacks here, and they actually look amazing. So yeah. Could you please introduce them to us?
Totally. So there's this company called Sakara. This is a detox bar, but it has it has charcoal in it, and that actually like cleanses your body and detoxes it, and also has like a bunch of yummy fruit, so it doesn't taste like charcoal, but it's like really good. It's watermelon jerky.
Wow.
And it's super yummy because we don't eat beef jerky, so we have watermelon jerky.
Yeah. So really having good and healthy snacks that you can kind of just put in your backpack and take along the way is really important.
Yeah.
Well, that's all the time we have for you today on the health and fitness segment. Gabby, thank you so much for letting us come into your suite. Let's taste this. Cheers. That's good. I could definitely fill myself up on that. We'll catch you next time. I'm Caroline.
All right, thanks, Caroline. We have to take another quick break, but when we come back, EVVYs host Jesse Lynn Hart will announce the nominees for the EVVYs Majestic Awards.
Wow, our debates are on fire.
Ah! Oh no, why did I say that? Ah! Oh no, I'm on fire still and it's so hot. Why am I doing this? Ah! Oh no, I'm still on fire, but one speechless on the Emerson channel. It's really good and full of action.
Welcome back to Good Morning Emerson. I'm here with Jesse Lynn Hart, one of the EVVYs Majestic hosts. So before we start, Jesse and I were talking before the show. We are a little bit nervous. We don't want to John Travolta it right before we say all these names. So we apologize in advance if we mispronounce your name or your project.
Yes.
So first category, Outstanding Live Audio Mix, Planet Armshake by Nick Del Olmo and Julius Kukla, Speechless Spring 2016 Episode 1 by Andrew Sclafani, Planet Space Base, Nick Del Olmo and Julius Kukla, Planet Kangaroo, Nick Del Olmo and Julius Kukla.
Outstanding Sound Design, Blank by Sarah Mansour and June Healy, Inspiration by Mitch Mormon, The Power to Be Free by Mason Muchnick, Daughters by Noah Kowalski.
Outstanding Motion Graphics, Take Charge by Reed Holtzman, Help Desk Promo by Tori DeYesso, Nevermind by Brian Demers, Mobile Device Management Promo by Tori DeYesso.
Outstanding Editing for Nonfiction, Talk With Me by Harry Brownstein, A Dialogue with Islam by John General, Kissed You Goodnight by So Choi and Maria LaSalle, Specialty Food by Harrison Jeffs.
Outstanding Editing for Narrative, Sterile by Jack Sabarine and Matthew Klein, Radiant by Tony Simonetti, Buying Bouquets by Harry Brownstein, Winter Vacation by Roger J.C. Lee and Cooper Vacheron.
Outstanding Lighting Design for Stage, Murder at the Carlsons by Nick Hatcher and Taylor Ness, Alchemy of Desire, Dead Man's Blues by Taylor Ness and Annalise Duboulay, Flawless Brown Stage 2015 by Annalise Duboulay and Romeo and Juliet by Jeremy Stein.
Outstanding Sound Design for Stage, Aloha Say the Pretty Girls by Charlie Tromador, Marvelous Oz by Bridget Driscoll and Jonah Godfrey, Anchortown by Charlie Tromador, Alchemy of Desire, Dead Man's Blues by Anna Drummond.
Outstanding Scenic Design for Stage, The Importance of Chastity by Joshua Warner, Romeo and Juliet by Andrew Cianez de la O, Alchemy of Desire, Dead Man's Blues by Andrew Cianez de la O, and Murder at the Carlsons by Joe Burt.
Outstanding costume design for stage, Murder at the Carlsons by Zeke St. John and Rosie Tabachnik, Marvelous Oz by Kitty Lipsky, Alchemy of Desire, Dead Man's Blues by Emily White, Romeo and Juliet by Rachel Dahl.
Outstanding director for stage, Marvelous Oz by Michael Levine, Aloha Say the Pretty Girls by Madison Geringer, Alchemy of Desire, Dead Man's Blues by Zach Mooney, Murder at the Carlsons by Claire Epstein.
Outstanding choreography, Legally Blonde by Jesse Lynn Hart, EUDT Presents POW by Emerson Urban Dance Theater, Flawless Brown Stage 2015 by Penelope De La Rosa, Alchemy of Desire, Dead Man's Blues by Alex Smith.
Outstanding lead actress for stage, Jane Reagan in The Importance of Chastity, Madeline Addis in A Doll's House, Penelope De La Rosa in Alchemy of Desire, Dead Man's Blues, Maggie Dunleavy in Aloha Say the Pretty Girls.
Outstanding lead actor for stage, Bean Nelson in How Carson McCullers Saved My Life, Jake Schmerischniak in Legally Blonde, The Musical, Alex Smith in Marvelous Oz, Zeke St. John in Alchemy of Desire, Dead Man's Blues.
Outstanding actor for screen, Connor Boyd in Te Vengo a Buscar, Zachary Battaglia in Socio, John Michael Mukai in Winter Vacation, and John Michael Mukai in The Perfect Interview.
Outstanding actress for the screen, Josephine Cooper in Racing the Sunrise, Kelly Hutt in Alone in the M. Woods in Winter Vacation, Christina Sherbon in Blank.
Outstanding television reporter, Jennifer Currier, Rafael Lopez, Shayna R. Ferriera, Priscilla Ligori.
Outstanding television personality, Amanda Breen, Sam Goldstein, Maggie Morlath, Ashley LaShawn.
Outstanding production design for studio television, Musicians Wanted, Jacob McCaslin, and The Jaywalkers by Emily Jacoby. Musicians Wanted, Planet by Andrew Skiles and Emily Jacoby. Campus Clash, ECW versus Stroop Waffle by Justin Cobelt. Musicians Wanted, Callaway by Andrew Skiles.
Outstanding lighting design for studio television, the 34th Annual Evie Awards by Nicholas Hatcher and Taylor Ness. Musicians Wanted, Jacob McCaslin and the Jaywalkers by Madison Young and Annalise Duboule. Musicians Wanted, Callaway by John Pooley. Musicians Wanted, Planet by Lily McMurr and Tyler Erickson.
Outstanding multi-camera direction, GME Episode 19 Fall 2015 Season Finale by James Piccirillo. Emerson Channel Sports by Austin Wilder. Closing Time with Kaylin Mahoney by Gabrielle Ruiz. Campus Clash Episode 1 by Will Hart.
Outstanding field TV series, Real Reactions Fall 2015 by Zachary Rezawali, Emily Kramer, Reverse Psychology by Chandler Kilgore Parshall and Jesse Frankel, The Quest for the Bottomless Shot Glass by Trevor Howell, TJ Roosh, Derek Wayne Abilo, Backyard Boston Cambridge episode by Jackie Chang, and Gabrielle Ruiz.
Outstanding news program, Good Morning Emerson, November 24th, 2015, by Andrew Skiles and Maggie Morlath. Good Morning Emerson, December 3rd, 2015, by Andrew Skiles and Maggie Morlath. EIV News at 6, December 3rd, 2015, by Andrew Lemos and Michael Kayanis. Noticiero WEBN, Terror in Paris, by Angelina Salcedo.
Outstanding written comedy sketch, Barnes & Noble by Julia Lebo. Deborah, the Interested Bachelor, Camera Operator by Sam Crichton. Scooby Boo and the Mystery Crew by Michael W. Kayanis Jr.
Outstanding writing for television, Shocking Morty by Rick and Morty, Spec by Harrison Jeffs. Broad City, Lador Vador by D.D. Kaufman. The Size of the Fight in the Dog by David Samuels. Closing Time with Amanda Breen, Episode 2, Writing Team.
Outstanding writing for stage, Murder at the Carlsons by Madison Geringer and Michael Levine. Bombshell by Jack Hobbs, Woe Be Gone by Jamie Davenport, and Won't Stay Silent writing team.
Outstanding writing for film, Racing the Sunrise by Amy Russo, The Happy Couple by Nicholas Hanley, Children of War by Lindsay Norden, Clara Laurent, Sterile by Matthew Klein.
Outstanding production design for a narrative, Harrison by Emily Bateman, Laura Wu, I Dance With You by Emily Petro, Resting in Peace by Mary Ling Gregory, Stop by Jocelyn Lee and Matthew Williams.
Outstanding animated film, Hydropolis by Pamela Mora, Ricky Downs, Egg Folks by Isaac Switzer, The Chase by Laura Porat, Homa by Amanda Horton, Christina Cattucci, Ricky Downs, Jordan Dombroff.
Outstanding cinematography, Harrison by Joe Angelini, Even the Homeless Have Wi-Fi and Blue Dreams by Taylor Jarvis Going by Brendan Reel, Everlast by Brandon Reel.
Outstanding single camera direction, Te Vengo a Buscar by Pablo Vaca, Take With Me by Peter Cannon, Lotto by Sally Nash, Winter Vacation by Roger J.C. Lee.
Outstanding intermediate film, House of Strings by Asher Harris, Anja Schwarzer, Hide and Seek by Sean Vaccaro, David Bradburn, Kyle J. Kosaska, Sean Vaccaro, David Bradburn, Kyle Zoka. The Exorcism of the Demon Girlfriend from Hell by Robert Teamstra, Nick Hanley, Sarah Domkowski, Robert Teamstra, Nick Hanley, and Sarah Domkowski.
Outstanding special production, Musicians Wanted, Calloway by Justin Kobelt, Will Hart, Hannah Gluckman, The Last Train to Funky Town by Christian Mudrick, Abby Skorupski, Musicians Wanted, Planet, by Justin Kobelt, Will Hart, Hannah Gluckman. Musicians Wanted, Jacob McCaslin, The Jaywalkers by Justin Kobelt, Will Hart, Hannah Gluckman.
Outstanding documentary, Diving into Detail by Harrison Jeffs, Satiety by Catherine Almateen, Legacy, The Story of Josh Zunick by Douglas Emerson, Cal Laird, Evan Goldstein, and Brendan Reel, Kickbacks to Comeback, Joe Ganim, and The Bridgeport Mayoral Election by Catherine Casey.
Outstanding studio television series, Campus Clash by Michael W. Kyanis, Kelly Tomaso, Nick Delomo, Common Agenda, S45 by John Daniel Deppa, Caroline Sullivan, Good Morning Emerson, Spring 2016 by Logan Reaver, Emily Frazee, The Box Score with Harris Rubinstein by Tom Little, Harris Rubinstein.
Outstanding theatrical production, Alchemy of Desire, Dead Man's Blues by Rare Works Theater Company, A Doll's House by Emerson Shakespeare Society, Murder at the Carsons by Rare Works Theater Company, and Flawless Brown Stage 2015 by Flawless Stage.
Outstanding cinematic achievement, 0 Degrees by Kyle Kozachka, The End of Something by Michael O'Donnell, Buying Bouquets by Evan Yee, Sofre by Gabrielle Volovich.
All right, well, congratulations to all of those nominees. And after another quick break, we will have our cooking correspondent, Jessica Shorter-Bonnie, in studio.
Introducing the stars of Emerson's number one morning show. This is Medina Shahi. She breaks the latest pop culture news. She also recently broke the bench press world record in Germany twice.
Genetics.
This is Chloe Teboe, always the first to break the hard-hitting news on the local and national scale. Also always the first person to pop up on your Tinder account.
I love meeting new people.
This is Malcolm Kellner, Minnesota native and sports extraordinaire.
It's true.
He was the second choice for the reporter position. Our first took a job at EIV. This is Sean Stackhouse, one of the two dynamic hosts leading the charge of the show. He will say literally anything that is on the prompter.
And I'm Lauren Fox.
This is the real Lauren Fox. She thought she would be hosting Good Morning Emerson alone. She claims there is no ill will between her and the producers. This is Noah. He's lighting.
Welcome back to Good Morning Emerson.
Now we go to entertainment reporter Medina Shahi with some pop style news.
Good morning, everyone, and here's what I have for you today. Nick Young and Iggy Azalea seem to be the perfect couple. Also, Nick Young and D'Angelo Russell seem to be the perfect best friends. However, D'Angelo recorded Nick talking about how he cheats on Iggy constantly. This video was also leaked by D'Angelo. Now, all the Lakers teammates hate D'Angelo. They refuse to sit next to him or acknowledge his presence. He has also ruined the dynamic of the team. Even though this all took place, Iggy still wore her engagement ring on the iHeartRadio Awards, which sparked questions. Sources say it is officially over, and others say they're trying to make this work out. All I know is that Iggy has been fighting the thought of suicide, and all this is doing is ruining her mental health. Good luck, Iggy. This Kardashian family is a whole mess. Blac Chyna has always been fighting with Kylie because of Tyga, and now while the Kardashians are on vacation, Blac Chyna posted a picture of her and Rob, and she had a big engagement ring on her finger. Her best friend Amber Rose even put on her Instagram a congratulations for the engagement and slammed Kylie. Blac Chyna has made news of being an aide to Rob, helping with his weight problems and depression. But this makes Tyga the uncle to his own son. Tyga spoke out and said that he is happy that the mother of his son is happy, but he is worried that this might affect his son in his innocent years. What great reality TV, don't you think? Amy Schumer is speaking out against Glamour magazine. Glamour labeled her as plus size and as a role model that inspires young girls. However, she feels that this is shaming her and disrespectful due to the fact they did not ask her if they can do this. She believes that this isn't good for the girls that look up to her. I don't know, Amy. I don't think this should bother someone that promotes body confidence, but it is understandable to speak if they didn't ask for your permission. But what do you guys think about this? Tweet us at GM Emerson and a retweet might be in your future. Well, that's all I have for you today, and let's get back to Sean and Lauren.
Thanks, Medina. Joining us now is Jessica Schoderbani, who's going to show us how to make some chips and dips using a Nutribullet.
Yes. So as we all know, spring is right around the corner. Trying to eat a little bit healthier. Bikini season's going to be coming soon.
Mm. So I'm going to get my beach bod ready.
Exactly. So a Nutribullet here, I honestly think this is a must-have for all young people, all college students, because you really are making every single one of the recipes here with clean, whole ingredients. You know exactly what's going into it. Plus, it tastes a lot better. At least I think so.
Yeah, this is great. I've only actually used this for smoothies before, so this is super refreshing to see some dips being made
exactly.
In it.
I love making this with smoothies, but you can also make so many dips and so many other meals. So let's get started. Sure. So the first one we have here is a salsa. All you need is some tomatoes. You can get cherry tomatoes or whole tomatoes, a little bit of lemon juice, a little bit of cilantro, a little bit of garlic, salt and pepper, and comes out perfect. And we're gonna eat it with whole grain pita chips, just because that's a bit healthier than like deep fried tortilla chips filled with salt and all that other bad stuff. So do you guys wanna maybe try some salsa?
Yeah, so this is a much better alternative than to say something like Tostitos. You can make it in your room, something like that.
And it literally takes 2 seconds with a Nutribullet. You can like just, you know, press it down, blend it up for literally 10 seconds, and you have a perfect homemade salsa. And you can sort of say you're cooking without necessarily having to cook, which is great.
That's really good, too.
Thanks. It is.
How long did it take to put all these ingredients together?
It literally took maybe a matter of 5 minutes. Once you have everything in place, you just put in the blender, and you're basically set.
And then awesome. I gotta say, that wins over that dining hall salsa.
Exactly. So it's perfect for, like, if you don't want to get the salsa on Taco Tuesday, just make your own.
Yeah. All right, so what are some of the other ones
that we have? So next we have up here is fresh homemade guacamole. So we just basically take avocado, garlic, salt and pepper, mash it all up, put a little bit of tomatoes, and you can really, like, tailor to what you want. So if you want a couple of extra spices in there, if you want it really spicy, add some jalapeno pepper. So try it out, maybe.
Yeah.
Do you put lemon in your guacamole?
I do like a little bit of lemon, so I put a splash of lemon juice. But as I said, since you're making it yourself with your own Nutribullet, you can put whatever ingredients you want in it. And then for our very last one here, we have the hummus. Do you guys like that guacamole? Is it good?
It is good. Perfect. I like it.
It's great guac.
Thanks. So we're going to actually have you guys blend our last recipe.
Okay. Let's do it together, Laura. Okay.
Okay.
So we just push it down?
Yep. Just push it down. Yep.
Is that enough?
That's good. That's perfect.
Look at that.
All right.
Oh. Okay. Whoa. And through the magic of television, it ends up like
Look
that.
Look at that.
So.
That's all right.
Perfect.
I'm going to have some hummus.
Unfortunately, that's all the time that we have today. Thank you so much for joining us. Congratulations to all of the EVVYs nominees. We'll see you next week.
See you then.